2017 finally led to the adoption of the regional roadmap, negotiations on which had begun but could not be completed in 2016. The CSO community has expressed deep disappointment over the roadmap as it remains weak and misses the important tools to strengthen regional cooperation towards achieving the 2030 agenda. For example, it fails to include the important area of international trade. The roadmap also remains ineffective by being too general. However, the roadmap is not cast in stone, and we continue to believe in its potential to become an effective document that can guide regional cooperation, especially in terms of garnering critical means of implementation that developing and especially least developing countries in the region urgently need. In fact, without substantial progress on means of implementation, most developing and especially least developed countries will fall far short of desired levels of implementation. We hope this year that the roadmap will progress with agreement on some concrete deliverables in the fields of key monitoring of implementation. We urge member states to commit honestly and seriously to populate the regional roadmap with specific and useful instruments addressing some of the MOI needs of the region, for example, in the areas of ODA, illicit financial flows, trade and technology. We are also disappointed our statement on means of implementation could not be read out, and we would like to submit our recommendations through the CSO consolidated statement that we'll submit officially and request to take our suggestions on board. We forward the following recommendations for the roadmap. We call on developed country governments in the region to increase their ODA spending, which has been declining if real ODA is calculated and exceeds the meager target of 0.7% of GDP, even with most developed countries have not met. On trade, which is glaringly absent from the document, we advocate for a comprehensive SDG compatibility impact assessment of the trade and investment agreements in the region, which are increasingly in size and scope, with inputs from CSOs who can gather grassroots experiences from the ground as well as provide technical analysis. Such an assessment can also be conducted by national governments for particular SDGs that are of priority to them. For example, food security, industrialization, and employment generation, provision of critical services, and so on. We would like to reiterate our recommendation that an open and participatory regional mechanism be set up that will evaluate the potential of environmental, gender, human rights, and socioeconomic impacts of new and emerging technologies and assess the impact of the control and concentration of technologies for development and the resultant skewed benefits to the people who should be the recipients. There should also be a regional body to promote locally developed community-based technologies. The discussions on a regional tax forum seem to have got stalled. Given the huge loss to the region, especially from developing countries, in terms of illicit financial flows, we call upon member states to pursue these so that some form of regional cooperation can guarantee agreed norms to recover such potential revenues that can partially meet the financial needs of achieving the SDGs. The elimination of structural barriers is the basis of genuine sustainable development for the people in the region. There is a need to address the root causes of inequality, conflicts and wars, in forms of large-scale resources grabbing, corporate hegemony, militarism, neoliberalism, trade, and patriarchy and fundamentalisms in the region. I'm going to be ending soon, Madam Chair. The regional work on SDGs must not be disconnected from the work pursued in other fora, both by governments and civil society at global, regional, and national levels, for example, in fora involving rights of indigenous peoples, women farmers, workers, fisherfolk, urban poor, LGBTIQ, people living with HIV and AIDS, young people, aging people, migrants, disabled and Dalit populations. The regional cooperation work must connect to people's movements and campaigns on genuine issues that are very much part of the 2030 agenda. Achieving the SDGs will be impossible without acknowledging the linkage with people on the ground and issues close to their heart and lives. Thank you.
Thank you very much. And I call upon constituency group of youth constituency developed by Reshma Thapa.